Hey guys, it's me. So, I thought I'd show you something a little bit different and do a product review. This is a painting that I've been working on. You can see that I started the lips and the eyes and everything. And this here is like his little diamond that I'm gonna, obviously you can't see the detail full well, but this is painter's tape. I'm gonna stick some painter's tape right on the edges of my painting here. I'm gonna do that because it makes a nice kind of clean edge, which obviously I don't usually care about too much, but also when you're painting, as you know, with watercolors, it's really important that you do this, because the issue is it's going to get warped, if you don't. So I like to make sure that I. All right. You gotta make sure that it stays flat. So there we go. Oh, I'll show you one that I've been working that I recently finished. And for that, I'll do my little product review. Let me put this there for a minute. So, I love watercolors a lot, And I recently got these watercolor paintbrushes, I guess, from it's Jane Davenport. So I got these at Michael's, and this is what I produced mostly with them. Definitely the hair, the little bubble that she's in, and this around here. I love it because it's just so easy to get a really bright color. I don't use watercolors. When I first started painting, I started using watercolors the wrong way. Like, you're supposed to wet down the paper and everything, and I didn't know to do that. So I was always using, the watercolors the wrong way. And now I do it on purpose, because I love the look of the bright colors. But I love watercolors. Some of my friends that use like acrylic paint or oil paint, they say, "Well, why don't you just use oils, or acrylics if you like that, high pigment?" And I was like, "Well, I really love watercolors, not just because they're like they tend to be a lot cheaper, but because I just love working with them." And so I'm just doing this to kind of talk to you, and you can have something to look at the same time, instead of, just looking at my face, because I don't have any makeup on, so I'm not going to show you my face. This, the flesh tone, I'll show you what I used for that though. Now I'm going to go in with a water brush. I swear by these. You can use them for like traveling or whatever, but I use them because they're just so convenient. You know what my problem is? Like, I will have a jar of water and then I'll leave it there for a couple of days. I'll forget about it. And then it stinks. Like, I guess the water like rots or something, and then it's just disgusting. It's so gross. And then I'm just like, "Oh my God, this is really nasty." So, if you can see, it adds like this really cool kind of effect. I'm gonna go on the other side here. But yeah, oh, let me show you what I used for the skin color. It's also Jane Davenport, and it's this little box. And I love it. I used, this is the color that I used for her skin color. I love this little box because it's small and it's portable. And if you're, an art supply hoarder like I am, you want smaller sized items because you've got a lot of shit. At least that's, how I am. Whenever, oh, I can't draw on that because my kids did something on it. Whenever I'm working with these brushes, you know, a lot of pigment comes out. So you're going to want to have a little napkin around when you use it. I'm not sure if they discontinued these or not, but these are by far my favorite form of watercolors that I have used in a while. And I only say that I'm not sure because I didn't see them the last time I went into Michael's. But I definitely like this is just the best form of watercolor, and I say that because it's the liquid itself in there, you know. And sorry, I'm concentrating. And I find that, because this is all pure liquid water, like watercolor, which I love. Yes, you can buy like the concentrated watercolors, like the, I have them somewhere. If I remember where I put them, I'll show you what I'm talking about. Like, okay. Like you can get like these. These are, you know, by, you know, the concentrated watercolors. And you can, of course, buy a set of these and you can fill them up, which I might also do. If you guys are interested in seeing how to do that, I can certainly make a video on how to do that within the next couple weeks or so. I know I haven't been posting a lot of videos, but I'm actually also going to school. I'm in college, online, but still. And that takes up a huge chunk of like space in my head. And, you know, and then I have kids and stuff and a day job. So it's not easy to keep up with it all. But I want to keep trying because I have some new ideas for things that I want to share with you guys and different kind of content that I'll be working on within the next year or so. So, yeah, I like these water brushes. If you want to know where I bought them, honestly, I think I just got them on Amazon. But that's how I got these. And I love the you know, how easy these watercolors are. And if you're wondering how, what I normally do with watercolors is I like to go around the edges, right, with the watercolors, and then I push it down, as you see, as you can see, you know, right now. So now I'm going to go here, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm a lefty, so I've got to be careful and watch myself. I go around the edges here. You can see there's a lot of generous flow of paint that's coming out. I buy lots of different forms of watercolors because I'm a crazy art supply hoarder that way. But these are definitely my favorites. It's really hard for me to find like a product that I just, that works exactly the way I want it to, that gives me the kind of pigment that I want it to, and everything like that. But so far, these definitely work. And you see how I'm just pushing the paint kind of down and, you know, making sure, again, I'm a lefty, so I have to make sure that I'm careful, because if not, you know, you can end up getting paint sort of all over the rest of the image, which is definitely not my desire right now. So my review of this product is I love it. I love it. I definitely think that she, I love when artists develop art supply products, because, you know, it really says something about them. I love these markers so much. They're not markers, they're paintbrushes. I love them. And I think that they're definitely worth the purchase. I think they're about 40, 50 bucks. I'm not being paid, you know, or compensated in any way to rave about them. I'm just raving about them because I love them. I have so many other forms of, you know, markers that I've used on, you know, the face. I've used these pro markers, which I'll make a video on those. I've used, you know, these kind of Japanese watercolor markers. But I really like these a lot because, like I said, the high pigmentation is really, really what I love. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do next, but my little review is done for now. And like I said, I used this is 90% is her product. This is watercolor crayons and this is a Sharpie marker. But the rest is basically, you know, her product. And, you know, it's really cool. Let me zoom out so you can see it a little bit better. It's just a really cool, like, I love the brightness of it. And this is what, you know, the Jane Davenport, you know, marker watercolor brushes do. I love it. So I'll be back next week or so. Leave in the comments to me what kind of videos you'd like to see me produce. And don't forget to subscribe and hit up my website. It's thecraftaholic.com. And thanks.